Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. This is Karuna teaching the course Computer Architecture and Organization. Fourth unit contains the following topics, out of which in this video we are concentrating on Universal Serial Bus. USB, Universal Serial Bus, which is used to connect keyboard, mouse, display devices, cameras to the computer. USB, Universal Serial Bus, is an industry standard developed through a collaborative effort of several computer and communications companies. USB supports different type of speeds of operations. Those are low speed, full speed, high speed. Coming to the port limitation, earlier we have discussed about serial port, parallel port. Serial port and parallel ports are used to transmit the data serially or parallelly. So at the time of transmission, user needs to open the computer box and install interfacing circuit to connect that port to the expansion bus of the processor. So the objective of this design of USB is user can connect more number of I/O devices to the computer without opening the computer box. It is a simple device and available at low cost also. Next, coming to the device characteristics. If you take data transfer between keyboard and display device, there may be a speed variations between keyboard and display device data transfers. Data transfer of keyboard based on the typing speed of the user. Okay, display device may display the characters at higher rates than the keyboard data transfers. So there may be a speed variations that we can say keyboard is having a asynchronous data transfer. And also if you take recording system, case of recording system, voice is detected by the microphone. And then that detected voice will be converted into electrical signals. Okay, so that signal may be analog in nature. Okay, so before going to process that signal, signal is to be converted into digital with the help of some sampling techniques. After processing that data, again the data will be converted into analog form to restore the original signals. Okay, so in this case, after sampling technique, the stream of the samples arrived at regular intervals of time. Okay, so that we can say isochronous data transfer. Here human record can capture at 8 kilohertz, which will record sound signal at 4 kilohertz. Okay, so there may be a speed variations in recording the voice. Okay, so the main objective of this USB device is to accommodate wide range of data transfer characteristics for I/O devices. Now coming to the plug and play feature, means any new device can be connected to the computer while system is operating. Okay, that system can detect the connected new device. So these are the features of USB port. Now coming to the architecture of the USB. The architecture of USB is like tree structure. Okay, so in this case, here host computer connected all the I/O devices through USB. Each node is having a device which is known as hub, and I/O devices, we can say leaf nodes are I/O devices being served, which are called functions in USB terminology. Okay, here root hub, which connects all the devices to the host computer. The data transfers takes place between host computer and I/O devices through packets of information. So here host computer communicates all the I/O devices through packets of information. Hub acts as a control point between I/O devices and host computer. Host computer can receive the data from I/O devices or can send the data to the I/O devices through hubs. A hub receives whatever the data from host computer transmit to the all I/O devices. Here each I/O device is assigned with unique address. Okay, so whenever host computer transfer the data to the I/O devices through hubs, then that data will be sent to all the I/O devices, but whatever the addressed I/O device, that will respond to that message. Different I/O devices are operating at different speeds. Likewise, here USB can transmit the data at various speeds also. Okay, for example, here hub A, hub B, okay, device C, device D. Okay, so here hub A serves device C at high speed data transfer. All the nodes are connected through point to point serial links. Okay, that link will be split. Okay, that's what can say this diagram known as USB split bus. So here suppose device C transfers the data at high speed, device D transfers data at low speed or full speed. Whatever the data is sent to the hub A through root hub at high speeds, that will continue to the device C, okay, at high speed, because device C high speed device. Okay, and then also hub A controls the data transfer. Hub A sends the data to the device D at low speed with the help of some delay circuits in hub A. Okay, likewise the speed of data transfer can split like this, high speed, low speed, according to the device data transfer speed operations. Next, addressing. I already told you each device has its own address. Okay, so initially the address is sent by the host computer to the device, then transfer the data to the device, then that address device will respond. Now USB protocols. All information transferred over the bus is organized in packets. So packet consists one or more bytes of information. Okay, that information transferred on USB can be divided into two categories. Those are control packet and data packet. Okay, so control packet consists all the control information or status of the data transfer, and also addressing a device to initiate data transfer. Okay, and also consists acknowledgement bits, and also checks whether data is received correctly or not. Okay, that kind of information also provided in control packet. Okay, so data packet, usually data packet carry information to all the devices. These are the two packets. I told you two categories of packets. Okay, so information transferred from host computer to I/O devices through packets. So token packet and data packet. Token packet consists packet identifier. Okay, these are the fields present in the token packet. Okay, first field is packet identifier, address of the I/O device, end of the packet, and cyclic redundancy check. Okay, so here packet identifier is used to identify the packet. So here it contains 8 bits. Okay, so packet identifier 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so here 4 bits are used to identify the packet. Okay, or we can say this, all 4 bits are used as true value of the packet. Okay, other 4 bits are complemented version of that packet. Okay, so here 4 bits. The first field of any packet is called the packet identifier, which identifies the type of that packet. Okay, those packet identifiers are transmitted twice. Okay, first time they are sent with their true values, and the second time with each bit will be complemented. So the 4 PID bits identify one of 16 different packet types. With this help of this packet identifier, data transfer can be derived, whether it is input data transfer or output data transfer. Okay, so this is address of the IO device. This is end of the packet, consists 4 bits. Cyclic redundance check. With the help of this 5 bits, checks whether data is received correctly or not. That is about token packet. Contains the status of the information. Okay, next coming to the data packet. So here data vary from 0 to 8192 bits. Okay, and also it sends first packet identifier bits and then data, and also checks whether data is transmitted or received correctly or not. Let us see how the transfer takes place between host computer and IO device. In this example, I am using output transfer. Okay, so host computer send the data to the output device. Okay, so before here host hub IO device. Okay, hub acts as a control point between IO device and host computer. Okay, so first host sends token packets to the hub. Okay, now then followed by data to the hub. Okay, so now hub checks whether data received correctly or not with the help of cyclic redundancy check. Okay, after that then hub sends acknowledgement to the host computer. Okay, then hub sends whatever the received data from the host to the output device. Token first, followed by data. Okay, so here also output device checks whether data received correctly or not. After that sends acknowledgement signal to the hub. Okay, next sends another data. Data 1, here send data 0, and then host computer sends another data. Before sending that data, host will send token packet to the hub. Okay, and then data 1 to the hub. Okay, then hub again check whether data received correctly or not. Okay, then sends the acknowledgement to the host computer. Okay, then whatever the received data token, that will be sent to the output device. Then again output device check data received correctly or not, and then send the acknowledgement signal to the hub. Likewise, data transfer takes place between host computer and IO devices through token packets and data packets of information. Isochronous traffic on USB. If you take music system, sampling technique must be used. So all the samples are transferred at regular intervals of time. Okay, at that time also USB can be used. This is start of frame packet. Contains packet identifier, frame number and cyclic redundancy check. Okay, so these are the bits assigned to each field. In case of sampling the data, host computer generates start of frame packet. Okay, and then send for every 1 milliseconds frame. Okay, so to access the new IO device. Okay, so IO device will respond for every 1 milliseconds. That means at regular intervals of time. That time must be synchronized with the clock signal in case of sampling technique. So here first host computer send this start of frame packet to the, send this packet to the IO device. After 1 millisecond, again next packet will be sent to the IO device. Okay, so here the fields are start of frame packet, yes, T3 or TN, token packet address is N. Okay, D nothing but data packet, A acknowledgement packet. Likewise, these control signals are sent to the IO devices before going to transmit the data. After that, data will be transferred. Those packets will be transferred to IO devices for every 1 milliseconds, or we can say regular intervals of time. Okay, likewise USB cable can be used in case of asynchronous data transfer and synchronous data transfer also. Electrical characteristics. So USB contains 4 wires. 2 wires are used for purpose of power transmission, 1 line for +5 volts, another line for ground. Okay, another 2 wires used to transfer the data. Coming to the questionnaire slide, what is the use of USB? What are the fields of token packet? What is mean by plug and play feature? Okay, thank you. We will meet in next video.